welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we are back with our AEW Unrivaled Collection figure reviews. Very excited, man. I feel like I haven't done an action figure review in a very long time. At least it feels that way. I don't know if it's, you know, if that's true or what the case is. I know it's been a little bit since an AEW figure review, guys, but here we have it today, guys. We are taking a look at Chris Jericho and Jake Hager from series number 6. We're also going to cover the Lucha Bros and MJF and Sheeta, rank the set, see where they all stand, compare some stuff, you know, crack everything out of the packaging, man. Today, we are finally completing our original incarnation of Inner Circle, which I'm really excited about. If you guys would like to pre-order these or grab these, you can do so over at Ringside Collectibles, WrestlingFigures.com. Use promo code MDTOYS to save yourselves 10% when shopping over there. But here's your front viewing window. Really nice stuff going on with both of these guys. We're keeping the same packaging. I feel like these AEW figures probably won't change packaging for a while if they ever do. I just don't see that happening. I think Jeremy's trying to keep it classic. He'll probably keep this packaging for a long time. You know, they got the numbers on the side and all of that stuff. So I feel like it's probably going to be this packaging for a while. But spinning it around, guys, you got the AEW logo there. You got number 46 and 45. I know that's going to bother some people that that's not flipped, and that's okay. On the back, you get images of Hagar or Hager. You know, Jericho likes to call him Hagar. Chris Jericho right there. You got the rest of the figures in the wave. A lot of people complaining about this wave, saying it's not a good wave. I don't think that's fair to say until we crack them out and, you know, we review all of them. But you got the image of Hager there and Jericho there. And being a big fan of both of these guys, I'm excited to crack them out and see what they're all about, guys. So with that being said, let's shut the hell up and crack Jake Hager and Chris Jericho out of their packaging. And there is Chris Jericho and Jake Hager out of the packaging. I'm looking like, well, we, you know, the first thing that we got going on right here. Again, I do like, of course, Chris Jericho was one of my favorite wrestlers, like, as soon as I started watching. I would say in 99, like, when I was 3-4 years old, the first time that I watched WWF or WWE, if you want to call it that, Chris Jericho was probably my first favorite wrestler ever. Him and Kurt Angle, and then later it became Chris Benoit. And those were always my guys, man. And ever since AEW picked up Jake Hager, I've been very excited for his career as well. And I've liked the role they've used him in. Not perfect by any means, you know. Everybody's got their issues and gigs. But here is Jericho and Hager, man. Liking the way they look. We are going to go through both of their accessories and everything like that. I guess what we can do is go ahead and do Jericho's accessories and then Jericho. And then we'll run it back and take a closer look at Hager's accessories and Hager. And then we are going to do some comparisons. So we're going to take a look at, you know, Mattel, Jack Swaggers, and Jake Hager's and compare head sculpts and do all of those different things, man. Let's dissect these figures and find out if Series 6 Hager and Jericho are worth the purchase. So for Chris Jericho's accessories, guys, you actually don't get a ton. You get the AEW championship, and then on out of the packaging, he actually has a scarf on, so if you pop his head off, you will be able to remove said scarf, and you guys will see on there, I think it says Le Champion Chris Jericho, and it's like his logo and stuff, which fits the figure nice and everything. He is wrestling in it on the back of the packaging. I don't remember him wrestling in it, but I guess that's a thing. I don't know. I guess I just don't pay attention as much, but if you want to put that on there, you just plug that on and then pop the head sculpt on there, and there you go. But as far as his accessory, guys, it is an AEW championship, which we have seen many times now. You know, it's come with multiple characters. We're in Series 6 now. They're going to keep pumping this out so that everybody has a chance to get it, but I will say, it feels a lot like the little bit of the bubbly Jericho, where, like, it's kind of flimsy. It's not, like, it doesn't have, like, the Mattel quality of the belt. It's kind of flimsy-whimsy, you know, so it's kind of hard to buckle together, but it will do so. It's just a little bit difficult, so be aware of that. You may not want to use this particular version, or maybe it's just mine, but I like it when it's the thicker quality rubber and it's easier to get on there, but there is Chris Jericho's accessories, man. Not a lot going on with it. So diving into Chris Jericho, guys, starting out with the head sculpt, we do have this new screaming head sculpt, which I think looks really good. I think the sculpt looks really nice. The likeness to Chris Jericho is definitely there. The hair color and the skin tone and everything looks good. You know, no issues with that. I think the sculpt is nice. It looks like Jericho. You know, we are going to compare it to his other head sculpts and stuff, but it's kind of cool that we get a smiley, we get kind of a pissed off, and now we have like a yelling Jericho. So, you know, we're progressing through there. So that is really nice to see. I like it. You know, it could be like a Walls of Jericho type screaming head. You know, you stupid idiot style screaming head. You know, there's a lot of stuff going on here. Same torso as before. He's got all of his tattoos on here. You guys will also notice the scarf again. Tattoos are looking pretty good. They look a bit different, I feel, than like his other figures, but it's probably just the skin tone, you know, that kind of throws it off a little bit or makes it look a tad different. I also have a little mark right here on the stomach. Don't like that. Don't know what all that is. Going down into the pants, you got the black and yellow pants right here. Kind of reminds me of the Top Talent Seth Rollins X-Men gear, kind of is what that reminds me of. I will say also that the legs kind of feel a little bit loose. Not like terrible Adam Hangman Page Series 5 loose, but they are a little bit more loose than, say, his Series 1 or other figures. But you guys know the deal on his black knee pads, black boots, black tights with the yellow designs. They match the scarf there. But that is pretty much your Chris Jericho AEW Series 6 figure. And then by order of release, here is our AEW and Rival Collection Chris Jericho's. From left to right, we have the little bit of the bubbly ringside exclusive. We have the Unrival Collection Series 1, the Unrival Collection Series 1B, and then the Unrival Collection Series 6. Now that I'm sitting here looking at them, I feel like I'm missing one or something, but I don't think so. No, I believe this is it. But we also have that 4-pack coming. We also have that Amazon exclusive coming. So Chris Jericho's are going to be made, man. One of the most popular names and everything. But comparing the head sculpts again, you have the smiley head sculpt in the pale skin tone. You do have the pissed off in the fixed skin tone. And then you have the yelling right there. Which one do you guys like better? Do you like the smiling, the pissed off, or the yelling? Personally, I mean, they all look like Chris Jericho to me. But I would say, I think I like the yelling one the best. Even though I'm not one for screaming expressions, I still think the likeness is probably the best there. And I like the hair color and sculpt and everything. Even though they're probably all the same, it just, I don't know, I think Series 6 is collectively better. But there is your Chris Jericho AEW and Rival Collection figure comparisons. Alright guys, so diving into Hager's accessories here, the biggest part of his accessories has got to be this cloth hoodie that looks immaculate. I really am impressed with this. You got the gold stripe at the bottom. It does Velcro in the back, which isn't the biggest deal, you know, you can't really see it, but it also has a hood on there. It's got the sleeves, the gold, you know, stripes going down the side there. Really nice accessory. The only thing about it is it does stain the figure, which I'll show you guys in the next slide. When it comes out of the packaging, you guys probably noticed the plastic around Jake Hager's waist and his arms and stuff. That's because I think this thing stains the figure, which sucks. I hate that, you know, you have to worry about that because, you know, if you're a mock collector, it doesn't really matter. But if you're a, you know, if you like to do pick feds and put your figures up on the shelf and pose them around and stuff like that, you can't, it's gonna suck if you take the jacket off and then they have black marks all over them, you know? So that's definitely an issue. I think it's just the ink that's in this black shirt. I honestly don't know how to get rid of that. I don't know if you could, I don't know if you could, like, you know, wash this and dry it once and it fix it. Like, if you put it in one of those baby care Ziploc bags or something. I don't know. I may test that one day, but this is a sick hoodie. I really like this accessory and everything like that. It looks good on the figure, as you guys saw, but there is that. And he also comes with interchangeable fists. But outside of the interchangeable fists and the hoodie, he comes with nothing else. So that pretty much wraps up Hager's accessories. I'm really excited to put this on, like, different guys. Like, once this guy hits retail, I'll probably grab a few just for this shirt so you can put it on Roman Reigns and, you know, different guys like that. I think The Rock would look cool, maybe even Cena. I mean, there's some cool ideas for this as well, so we'll see about that, but that is it for Hager's accessories. So taking a closer look at Hager's head sculpt, man, I think this is actually going to be a running change. As you guys will see, his hair is, like, completely red and, like, reddish brown, and I don't think, first of all, it's not accurate at all. Second of all, I think that there is a running change that's going to change his hair to blonde, and this head sculpt just kind of gives me, like, Daniel Bryan, Abe Lincoln, I don't know, all kinds of crazy, like, other options other than Jake Hager, man. So, like, I think there is some likeness there, but the red color definitely throws it off and doesn't make it look like himself. So we will have to fix this up on surgery or somewhat, you know. We're gonna try to put the whole wave through surgery or see what we can touch up and stuff like that. But going down into the torso, I do believe this is the John Moxley torso, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong about that. It looks like it. Got your standard arms, no wrist tape or anything. You have, like, this Southern California or, like, I don't know, it kind of reminds me of, like, USC Trojan style, like, border going around the trunks there in the gold. You get some nice camo green, some gold stripes on his boxer shorts. You get a tattoo right there. Going down into the legs, you got no knee pads on this guy. You got, like, some skinny calves, and then you have his wrestling boots there, which look good and accurate in the black and green. And this does have boot rotation here. He does have upper thigh cut, and the legs don't feel super loose. I just will say that I feel like the, I don't know, just standing up, I don't know, it's not as bad as other figures. It's just, I think, since his legs are so long, it's hard to stand, especially since it gets skinnier at the bottom there. But he gets some pretty good articulation. He can look all the way up and down there. You get a little bit of a head rock, you know, you get the double jointed arms. It can rotate all the way. If you guys were wondering, there is the little black scuff on his shoulder there. So I don't think that's able to be removed. He does have his tattoo on the back, by the way, but I don't think these little black marks on the shoulders are able to be removed. So that is kind of frustrating, but yeah. So definitely think about that. I mean, you might could switch out the torso with John Moxley and then acetone the tattoos off, or maybe switch these arms onto a John John Moxley and then put, you know, the head sculpt on there. I don't know. Maybe we could play around with it if you wanted to get rid of the black markings on the shoulder. But if you put the hoodie back on there, it's going to stain it anyway. So it's just a big, you know, a big razzle dazzle there. There's some nice straps on the boots. They did a good job on these boots, man. I bet this is like exactly how his boots are sculpted. But that is the Jake Hager figure, man. What do you guys think? And then for your Jake Hager slash Jack Swagger figure comparisons, guys, here is the Series 6 Jake Hager versus my version of, you know, the American Patriot style Jack Swagger that is on MDT Live as the U.S. Champion. So here's this fix-up I made there, and then you got the suited body over here. I definitely like this head sculpt more. I wonder if I can switch and put this head sculpt on this body. I made this head sculpt interchangeable, so hopefully this will look okay on here, and we'll just see about it. I don't think I'm going to put him in this gear. I like the American Patriot style gear that I have him in if, you know, when I can get a pick fed back up and running. But there is that head sculpt on that body, and that looks pretty John Brown good, I'd say. I like it. I think it totally works. I mean, maybe the legs may be a little skinny, but geez, man, that actually got a little something special going on there, young man. That's good scale. The skin tone looks pretty much identical. I like that. Good work there, men. And then I doubt this head sculpt will go on here. Yeah, don't think so, Brad. Do not think so. And here's Hager with the MDT US Championship in this gear. If you guys wanted to see what that looked like, there is that. And if you guys wanted to see the full Inner Circle all together, here we have it. Ortiz, Sammy Guevara, Chris Jericho, Jake Hager, and Santana all up next to each other. And I like it. I think they all look great. I wish we had like a full Inner Circle shirt pack or something that we could get. But all in all, man, I think all of Inner Circle looks great. Really excited for them. I think they all turned out great. They all look great up together. I think, you know, again, if you had them all in Inner Circle t-shirts and, you know, you made a display, I think that would be sweet. But our original incarnation of Inner Circle is complete. But that is pretty much going to do it for this 2-in-1 review on AEW Unrivaled Collection Series 6, Chris Jericho and Jake Hager. Man, let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. Stay tuned for tomorrow's video where we're going to do two more in the set. Before we get out of here, guys, let's get into our random shout out. And this shout out is going to go to Isaiah McGlon or McGlon, who says, for some odd reason, I feel like you could put the Scarlet head scan on the Liv Morgan Elite. By the way, never crossed the line like Amazon. And that is probably a good idea, bro. I bet we could do that. The only thing about it is probably the skin tones are a little bit off. So we'll have to see about that and see, you know, exactly how that plays out, if that will be possible. However, that is a good idea. I like that idea right there. We'll have to play around with that and everything like that. I went back to my Walmart. Nothing there. Literally 2 John Cena basics and 2 Karrion Kross basics. So I'm not sure if my toy hunt made everybody go out and buy the rest of everything that was there. But there was a ton of stuff. Now there's nothing. So hopefully that means they'll order more and we'll get some good stuff in here, guys. But again, if you would like to grab these figures, man, go over to Ringside Collectibles. Use promo code MDTOYS to save yourselves 10%. Huge shout out to Isaiah for his comment there. And I would say overall, I like it. You know, if you missed out on the first few Jerichos, definitely grab this one. And Hager's a pretty good figure. I think the running change will be better, but I really like the cloth hoodie. And you may want to wait for it to hit retail. And I do not like that the shoulders are like that and the legs are kind of, you know, like the skinniness of the legs kind of makes him hard to stand up. And Jericho's legs are a bit on the loose side compared to his first figure. So I'm not sure if they changed something. But thank you guys for watching. Subscribe to the channel and don't cross the line like the freaking hoodie that decided to stain my Hager shoulders. You crossed the line. I've been